Hi students, yesterday we have done the fourth sum. Today we will be solving the second sum of final account in page number 55. Again, final account, I think we are going to prepare four accounts: the trading account, profit and loss account, partners capital or current account, and balance sheet as on that date. Now, till yesterday, that is three sums I have already taught, question 1, 3, 4. In that, current account was not given, it was capital account given. It means it is a fluctuating capital method. Today's sum, what we are going to solve, it is fixed capital method. So how we come to know it is fixed capital method? For that, if you see on credit side, capital balance of partners Mitesh and Mangesh is given along with current account balance Mitesh and Mangesh. So when in the problem, if current account is given, then we have to understand that it is fixed capital method, as partners current account is given in the problem. Now when current account is given in the problem, so you will prepare partner's current account instead of partner's capital account. Means how you draw partner's capital account, same way you draw partner's current account. Whatever adjustments, whatever postings you are doing in partner's capital account, same postings you will do in the partner's current account. Only thing, the capital will not be written. In the place of capital, current account will be written. Now the balance of capital, that is Mitesh and Mangesh, it is given as 150,000 and 50,000. This amount you will write directly in the balance sheet liability side. You will not show any changes as it is a fixed capital method. So you will write directly in the you will write capital account directly in the balance sheet liability side. Okay, now we'll start with solving the sum. As regular basis, we will be solving the first postings. Stock trading account debit side, building balance sheet asset side, carriage trading account debit side. See, always student, I'm just interrupting. Whenever you are recording or whenever you are hearing the video or audio, please see to it that you first make the column and keep ready. Okay, now partner's name you don't write. Okay, but at least you make the column and keep ready, so that as you hear my audio, as you see my video, you can keep posting also, so that it will help you in understanding. Because before also I told you many times, VK means you cannot just listen and just sit idle, you will understand. Unless and until you will not practice, you will not keep on solving, then only you will understand. Okay, so I just proceed with our postings. So the first is trading account debit side, stock, building balance sheet asset side. Building as adjustment, so write inner column 48,500. Carriage profit trading account debit side 1780. It is having an adjustment, so write in the inner column. Carriage is having an adjustment, so write in the inner column. Carriage 1780. Then you have factory insurance. See, if it is only insurance, then you can say it is an element of profit and loss account. But the word factory, when the factory is given, so it should be placed in trading account debit side. Factory insurance should be placed in trading account debit side. Postage you will write in profit and loss account debit side 1600. Bills receivable, balance sheet asset side, bills receivable balance sheet asset side 13,700, sundry debtors balance sheet asset side 52,200. Right in the inner column, it is having two adjustments, so leave three lines. Debtors 52,200, it is having two adjustments, so leave three lines. Return inward is sales return. So in trading account credit side, first you write buy sales, amount you write later once sales comes, minus return 1600 in the inner column you write. Then we have purchases will be in trading account debit side, purchases 68,900, purchase is having a return outward, that is purchase return is given on credit side, so purchase amount you write in inner column 68,900. Then audit fees, profit and loss account debit side, audit fees, it is having an adjustment, so write in the inner column audit fees 1800, write in the inner column. Loose tools assets 32,000, write in the balance sheet asset side. Manufacturing means it is expenses incurred for manufacturing goods and services, so it is done in the factory, and all factory expenses are recorded in trading account debit side. So in trading account debit side, you write the manufacturing expenses 1820. Electricity charges, write in the profit and loss account debit side. Electricity charges, profit and loss account debit side, the amount is 2600. Then we have general expenses profit and loss account debit side. General expenses profit loss account debit side 3400. Export duty profit and loss account debit side 1000. Cash in hand is an asset, so you write in balance sheet asset side cash in hand 75,000. Bank balance again it is an assets 29,000. Conveyance का मतलब होता है traveling expenses. Conveyance you write in profit loss account debit side 4,100 conveyance. Furniture balance sheet asset side 64,000. Furniture should be recorded in balance sheet asset side 64,000. Salaries 2000, it is having an adjustment, so write in the inner column salaries is 2000. It is given salaries, so you will write in profit and loss account debit side salaries. Then you have rent, rates and taxes. Rent, rates and taxes, 3,700. Profit loss account debit side, rent, rates and taxes. Then we have drawings. Drawings, we write in partners current account instead of partners capital account, as your current account balance is given to you. So partners current account debit side, partners current account debit side, two drawings, 1200 and 2200. 1200 and 2200. Credit side, you have sundry creditors. Sundry creditors is a liability, 38,000. Sales, you write in trading account credit side by sales, 1,75,000. So 1,75,000 is a sales and return is 1,600. So subtract 1,700 minus 1,600, it comes to 1,73,400. Capital, write in balance sheet liability side. Do not write in partner's current account, write in balance sheet liability side. Mitesh and Mangesh, 1,50,000. Mangesh 50,000. So 1,50,000 plus 50,000, it comes to 2 lakh rupees. Then in the credit side, again there is outstanding salaries is given to you. So write outstanding salaries in the liability side, 2,000. Bills payable, 18,000. Bills payable is 18,000. Return outward is 1,800. Return outward is 1,800. This you will write in trading account debit side, less from purchase. Trading account debit side, less from purchase, 1,800. Current account, Mitesh and Mangesh. You will write in partners current account credit side. Now see, current account balance can be both the side given. It can be given debit side or it can be given in credit side also. This I have told in the introduction of the chapter. So here it is given credit side. So it is having a credit balance. So write on credit side by balance brought down. The balance is 3,000 and 2,000. So with this, we end up our postings. Now we go for adjustments. The first adjustment, Mitesh and Mangesh are sharing profits and losses in the ratio 3:1. Mitesh and Mangesh are sharing profits and losses in the ratio 3:1. This is the profit sharing ratio. So that you will be using this 3:1 in the net, in the profit and loss account when we get net profit. So when you get the net profit, so that net profit will be divided in the ratio 3:1 among the partners, Mitesh and Mangesh. Second adjustment is partners are entitled to get commission at 1% each on gross profit. Partners are entitled to get commission at 1% each on gross profit. So, I think partners are given commission over here and the commission is 1%, and this 1% is to be calculated on gross profit. So, for that, first of all, you should get what is a gross profit. So you will get gross profit only when you close the trading account. So we'll have to wait for that. So second adjustment we will do only after closing the trading account. Adjustment number 3.
The closing stock is valued at ₹23,700. Closing stock is valued at ₹23,700.
Closing stock, it has two effects. The first effect is trading account credit side by closing stock. Trading account credit side by closing stock, ₹23,700. And the second effect is balance sheet asset side closing stock, ₹23,700.
Fourth adjustment, outstanding expenses, audit fees 400, carriage 600. So audit fees you have written in profit and loss account debit side, two audit fees 1800. Usme aap add karo outstanding 400. So 1800 plus 400 will give you 2200. Ye aapka outstanding hua, pehla effect hua. Iska second effect hoga balance sheet mein. यहाँ पे लिखोगे आप आउटस्टैंडिंग ऑडिट फीस 400, कैरेज पे आउटस्टैंडिंग है 600, कैरेज आपने लिखा है ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में, टू कैरेज 1780 प्लस करो 600, कितना मिलेगा आपको 2380। कैरेज में ऐड करो आउटस्टैंडिंग 600, तो 1780 प्लस 600 आपको मिलेगा 2380। दिस विल बी आउटस्टैंडिंग कैरेज विच यू राइट इन द बैलेंस शीट लाइबिलिटी साइड, आउटस्टैंडिंग कैरेज 600। बिल्डिंग इज वैल्यूड एट ₹46,500। बिल्डिंग का वैल्यू दिया है 46,500। सो सबसे पहले आप क्या करोगे, बिल्डिंग का आउटर कॉलम में लिखना है अमाउंट 46,500, बिल्डिंग का इनर कॉलम में लिखा है 48,500। अब नेक्स्ट लाइन पे आउटर कॉलम में लिखो 46,500। अब ये दोनों को माइनस करो, सबट्रैक्ट द बोथ। ऑन सबट्रैक्टिंग बोथ दैट इज 48,500 में से 46,500 माइनस करो, you will be getting 2000 rupees. This 2000 is depreciation. This 2000 rupees is depreciation. Depreciation you will write in second effect in profit and loss account debit side, to depreciation on building 2000. Clear? Sometime percentage is given to you, sometime amount is given to you. So here amount is given. So what you will do, you will subtract the new amount from the old amount. The difference whatever is there, it is called depreciation. It can be appreciation also. Any asset ka value badhta bhi hai, to appreciation agar hota hai, to hum log usko likhenge profit and loss account ke credit side mein. But final account mein bahut rare case mein sab milta hai ki appreciation hua hai. Theek hai? In other chapters you may have this appreciation. Then sixth adjustment, furniture is depreciated by 5%. Furniture is depreciated by 5%. So you see the furniture amount. Aapka furniture amount kitna hai? See the furniture amount, 64,000. Calculate 5% on 64,000. So you will be getting 3,200. So 64,000 minus 3,200 will give you 60,800. Provide next adjustment. अच्छा इसका second effect, furniture का adjustment का second effect. First effect आपने asset से minus किया है, 64,000 में से आपने minus किया है, 5% will give you 3,200. इसका second effect कहाँ पर आएगा? Second effect आएगा profit and loss account के debit side में, to depreciation on furniture. To depreciation on furniture 3,200. Provide interest on partner's capital at 2.5%. Provide interest on partner's capital at 2.5%. Now a interest on capital, interest on capital, it is an एक्सपेंस फॉर द बिजनेस, इंटरेस्ट यानी जो पार्टनर्स जो बिजनेस में पैसा लेकर आते हैं, जैसे यहाँ पे मितेश ने मान ले 50,000 लाया है, मंगेश ने 50,000 लाया है, तो ये बिजनेस के लिए एक लाइबिलिटी है और उसके ऊपर हमें इंटरेस्ट पे करना है. बिजनेस हैव टू पे इंटरेस्ट, सो इट इज़ अ लाइबिलिटी, इट इज़ एन एक्सपेंस फॉर द बिजनेस. सो एज इट इज़ एन एक्सपेंस फॉर द बिजनेस वी राइट इन प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट डेबिट साइड. As it is an expense, we write in profit loss account debit side. We write in profit loss account debit side to interest on capital. So interest on capital, दो partner है, दोनों के ऊपर आएगा, मितेश और मंगेश. तो मितेश का है, अभी आप कौन से अमाउंट पर निकालना है, उन्होंने जितना लाया उसके ऊपर निकालना है. उन्होंने कितना लाया, 1,50,000 मितेश ने लाया है और मंगेश ने लाया 50,000. सो ऑन 1,50,000 on 1,50,000 you will calculate 2.5% got it. So when you calculate 2.5% it comes to 3750. similar way on 50,000 you calculate 2.5% it comes to 1250. so this will be written in profit loss account debit side to interest on capital, Mitesh and Mangesh. So 3750 plus Mangesh 1250, it comes to 5000. 3750 plus 1250, it comes to 5000. इसका सेकेंड इफेक्ट किधर आएगा, पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में आएगा बाय इंटरेस्ट ऑन पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में लिखा जाएगा बाय इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल 3750 एंड 1250. By interest on capital 3750 and 1250. उसके बाद है goods of rupees 900 were taken by Mangesh for his personal use. Goods of rupees 900 were taken by Mangesh for his personal use. यानी कि मंगेश ने 900 का goods लिया है for his personal use. तो इसका first effect आएगा ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में. द फर्स्ट इफेक्ट विल बी इन ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट क्रेडिट साइड बाय गुड्स टेकन बाय मंगेश फॉर पर्सनल यूज 900 रुपीज. एंड द सेकेंड इफेक्ट विल बी इन पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिट साइड. सेकेंड इफेक्ट विल बी पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट डेबिट साइड two drawings in the Mangesh column 900. two drawings in Mangesh column you write on 900. two drawings 900. then the ninth adjustment, write off rupees 1000 as bad debts and maintain RDD at 3% on sundry debtors. so first effect what you will do is you will write less from debtors are minus karoge. dekho balance sheet jab dhyan se dekho wahan pe debtors hai, debtors 52,200 hai, usme se new bad debt ko minus karo. new bad debt minus karo 1000 rupees. so 52,200 mein se 1000 gaya, kitna bach gaya 51,200. usme se 3% निकालो, 51,200 का 3% निकालो. डू नॉट कैलकुलेट 3% ऑफ द डेटर्स, यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट 3% ऑफ द अमाउंट आफ्टर डिडक्टिंग द न्यू बैड डेट. सो 52,200 में से 1000 माइनस करो, यू विल बी गेटिंग 51,200. ऑन 51,200 यू कैलकुलेट 3%, 1536 इट कम्स टू. सो 51,200 कैलकुलेशन कर सकते हो, 51,200 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3 डिवाइडेड बाय 12 सॉरी 100 51,200 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 3 डिवाइड बाय 100 इट कम्स टू 1536. ओके सो माइनस किया कितना आएगा 49,664 51,200 माइनस 1536 यू बी गेटिंग 49,664. इसका सेकेंड इफेक्ट, द सेकेंड इफेक्ट ऑफ इट, आप देखो प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट डेबिट साइड दिख रहा है आपको, वहाँ पर आपने लिखा है पहले से टू बैड डेट, आपने लिखा नहीं होगा तो आप अभी इक्वेशन लिख लो वहाँ पर, क्योंकि बैड डेट ट्रायल बैलेंस दिया ही नहीं था. तो हम लोग अभी उसका इक्वेशन लिखते हैं, टू बैड डेट प्लस न्यू बैड डेट प्लस न्यू आरडीडी, एक लाइन छोड़ो, माइनस ओल्ड आरडीडी, यू विल बी गेटिंग समथिंग. सो अभी टू बैड डेट ओल्ड नहीं दिया है ना, टू बैड डेट नहीं दिया तो वो डैश ओवर है, टू बैड डेट के सामने डैश डाल दो, प्लस न्यू बैड डेट 1000, आपको बैलेंस शीट एसेट साइड से मिल गया 1000, फिर न्यू आरडीडी 1536 वो आपको मिला बैलेंस शीट के एसेट साइड से. तो दोनों को प्लस करो, 1000 प्लस 1536 प्लस करो, यू विल बी गेटिंग 2536. ओल्ड आरडीडी दिया नहीं है फॉर डैश, राइट इन द आउटर कॉलम 2536. क्लियर? Now we have second adjustment left out, but for doing the second adjustment we'll have to close first trading account. So when we close a trading account, same manner I think I've told you, total the debit side first, debit side ko total karo first, credit side ka total karo second. डेबिट साइड का जो है 225,000 प्लस करो 67,100 से 2380 2700 1820. क्रेडिट साइड में है सेल से 1,73,400 प्लस 900 प्लस 23,700. ये तीनों को प्लस करने के बाद व्हेन यू ऐड अप ऑल दिस थ्री, जब आप तीनों को प्लस करोगे यू विल बी गेटिंग 1,98,000 सो फ्रॉम दिस 1,98,000 में से आप सब्ट्रैक्ट करो 25,000 67,100 फिर 2380 फिर 2700 डेबिट का मच, क्योंकि यहाँ पर भी क्रेडिट साइड ज़्यादा है, यानी यहाँ पर ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट है. माइनस करने के बाद आपका ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट आता है 99,000. योर ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट कम्स टू 99,000. So you will write two gross profit carried on 99,000. Two gross profit carried down 99,000. Now these gross profit you transfer to profit loss account credit side, by gross profit brought down 99,000. By gross profit brought down 99,000. Now you close the profit and loss. Before closing, there is a second adjustment pending. Partners are entitled to get commission at 1% each on gross profit. Yani dono ko bhi 99,000 ka 1% dono partner ko dena padega as a commission. As commission you have to give to both the partners. So kya likhoge? प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में लिखो टू कमीशन. प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में लिखो टू कमीशन, मितेश इनर कॉलम में लिखो 990 कैसे मिला आपको 99,000 को मल्टीप्लाई करो 1/100 से. तो 1/100 से अगर मल्टीप्लाई किया तो आपको मिलता है 990. ठीक है, तो इट कम्स टू 990. तो मितेश के सामने लिखो 990, मंगेश के सामने लिखो 990, दोनों को ऐड करो 990 प्लस 990 आपको मिलेगा 1980. दिस अमाउंट यू राइट इन पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट क्रेडिट साइड. सेकेंड इफेक्ट कहाँ जाएगा,
पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में जाएगा, पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट क्रेडिट साइड में जाएगा। ऑन क्रेडिट साइड यू राइट ऑन बाय इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल, ऑन क्रेडिट साइड यू राइट ऑन बाय इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल 3750-1250। Sorry. By commission 990
अच्छा इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल का मैंने शायद सेकेंड पे बोला नहीं था आपको लग रहा है। तो इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल का पहला इफेक्ट आया प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में, सेकेंड इफेक्ट आएगा पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में। सॉरी आई जस्ट फॉरगॉटन टू गिव द सेकेंड इफेक्ट ऑफ पार्टनर्स इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल। फर्स्ट इफेक्ट आएगा ट्रेडिंग प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में एंड सेकेंड इफेक्ट आएगा पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में। ओके नाउ एज रेगुलर बेसिस यू हैव टू क्लोज द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट। जो भी डिफरेंस आएगा आई थिंक नेट प्रॉफिट आने वाला है वो आप क्या करोगे डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करोगे इन द रेशियो 3:1 एंड दैट अमाउंट विल ट्रांसफर टू पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट। देन वी क्लोज द पार्टनर्स करंट अकाउंट, the difference will appear on partner's current account debit side. This amount will be transferred to balance sheet liability side under the heading current account. I hope the sum is very clear to all. If at all any doubt is there, please let me know. Students, I think many are not solving their sums. Because I am not getting any doubt, students are asking doubt, very few children are asking doubt. So, whatever we are giving these YouTube lectures, keep it in mind that we are not going to repeat it again. So, make it a point that this time, whatever you are having during lockdown at your home, please maintain these notes, solve these sums. By hearing the video, audio, you are not able to understand. See the solution, write the solution in the notebook, and then you see. If you have any doubt, please children, don't hesitate to ask. Make maximum utilization of this time. Okay? So, I'm just ending my lecture now. I'm ending the lecture. After uploading this in your WhatsApp group, I'll be uploading the solution also. But solution is only a help for you. It's not that if solution is given, you just directly copy in your notebook. Make it a point first to understand, listen the video, listen the audio, try to solve, and then you cross-check with the solution whatever is given to you. It will help you a lot. Okay? Thank you, class.